Hi, my name is Riata Scott, and I'm with the Division of IT's IT Training Department at the University of Missouri, Columbia. In this series of InDesign CC tutorials, we're going to work with linked documents. And as you may know, InDesign automatically links, rather than embeds, images that you add. Text files and word processing documents, however, are not linked by default unless you change the preferences. The first thing we'll do today is change the link document's preferences for the document that I currently have open. So we'll go to Edit, all the way at the bottom, hover Preferences, and then choose File Handling. And we want, down here in the Links area, we want to put a check mark beside Create links when placing text and spreadsheet files. So this will only apply to this document. All of our other documents, new documents that we create, won't automatically create linked documents. So I'll click OK. And what I'm going to do is put a little return address text box right here. So let's go to File and Place. And we'll choose addressonly.txt, and that's a address file I created. Just says 123 Zoo Avenue. By the way, there's actually no zoo in Columbia, Missouri, but we wish there were one, so we created a fake one. And I'll click Open, and I'll just drop that right there. And that is much bigger than I need, so I'll just scroll down here and double-click that little box to snap it up here. All right, I am going to hover a corner until I get that curved arrow, and I'll spin it around. There we go, that's straight. I'll just drag it over here, place it under the logo. So that document is now linked. Let's see if we can, don't need it quite that big. There we go. So I'm going to save and close this document. And by the way, this is on the master page. And note that this text file has a link on it, so that lets you, or this text frame, sorry, has a link on it that lets you know that it's a linked file. Usually you won't have that on text frames like you see on images. That's a linked document also. So I'm going to save and close this file. I'll just close and then say yes to save it. And then I'm going to open that document. Hold on. I believe this is the wrong one. Well, let's see, it might be here. All right, and we will change that to 1234 Zoo Avenue, and I'll just close it and say save. Hopefully that's the right one, or I'll have to redo this video. And then we'll open our document again. File open recently, or recent, that's the one we want. And notice it wants to update a link, so I'm going to say don't update links just so we can take a look at it. And we can see here, there's a little warning icon that thing isn't linked. And then right here in, let's see what page we're on. We are still on the back master page. And if we came down here, we can see it there as well because this is part of the master page items. So let's just come back up here. So all we need to do, this is just letting us know that this is, since it's linked, it has an old address, so it's still showing 123. And if we click that once, it turns to 1234 Zoo Avenue. So there are some cases where this is helpful to have this. In our next video, we're going to show you how to bring in word process documents, and we have to map the styles because you know we have paragraph styles in here, like for our headings and stuff, and you can do the same in Word. And so it's nice that you can bring that in and actually map the styles so it will change to the correct style. So we're going to have to show you how to do that one next, and hopefully you'll watch that video too.